Hello friends, this is mobile phone controlled irrigation system. So basically in this project we are going to ease the life of the farmer. So what we are doing, this is the water pump. So this water pump farmer can control from anywhere in the world. So for the demo purpose we are using this small motor, but you can use the big motor as well, because this is also working on 230 volt and the big size motor will be also working only 230 volts. So this is the hooter. So this hooter the farmer can on and off 2-3 times during the night time, and all the animals around the field will go away by hearing such a strong sound. So these are the level sensors. So these level sensors will detect the water level. So whenever the water level will be reached to the desired level, then the water pump would be off. Okay, let me just show you the working. So basically let me just tell you this bulb as well. So this bulb is type of extra feature. So farmer can on and off this bulb whenever he need. Or this is also working as a little bit security feature, because whenever the farmer if there is some threat of theft in the fields, then the farmer can on and off 2-3 times this bulb as well. So someone if there would be someone around the field, then he will run away because he will think that there is someone in the field. That's why bulb is on and off, right? Okay, now let me just show you the working. So manually also you can control, wireless also you can control this project. Let me first show you the manual operation. So if you press 1, bulb is on. If you press 2, bulb is off. If you press 3, motor is on and indicator is also blinking because field is not full. So here by pressing 3 you will see the automatic operation. Okay, now the water sensor are far away from each other, so but water level when rise, so water level will make a link between these two, and then the motor will be automatically off like this. Let me just manually do this. So whenever the sensor will touch each other through water, then motor would be automatically off. If the water level will go down, then again there will be distance between the sensor, okay, and again the motor would be off if water will touch the above sensor like this. Okay, now let me just show you the by pressing 4 you can off this motor. Now motor is off. By pressing 5 you can control this hooter. So if I press 5, if I press 6, this hooter would be off. Now if I talk about the technicalities of this project, so the detail you can find in the description given below. You can just directly go to the circuitsbazaar website.com. This is 230 volt cable and this is the transformer. This transformer is converting this 230 volt AC into 12 volt AC, and then there is a bridgeway rectifier. Bridgeway rectifier will convert 12 volt AC into 12 volt DC. Then there is a filter circuit. Filter will filter out any AC component in the power supply. Then there is a 7805 voltage regulator which will convert 12 volt DC into 5 volt DC. Then this 5 volt DC will be utilized by the circuit like the communication section and the microcontroller section. The microcontroller we are using over here is 8051 microcontroller. If I talk about the relay circuit, then this is the electromechanical 12 volt relay. And these two transistor acting as a Darlington pair, these are the BC547 transistor which will amplify the current coming from the microcontroller so that this amplified current can drive the relay. Then the relay will further drive either motor, either bulb or either hooter. So like this circuit, we have the same circuit like this one, same circuit like this one. Okay, if I talk about the communication section, then this DTMF tone will travel through this headphone to the circuit, and then you can see that this DTMF circuit, the IC we are using is MT8870 or HT9170. Then this IC will generate the 4-bit data. Let me just show you. So if you will press, 1, then you can see 0001 data. If you will press 2, data will be 0010. If you will press 3, data would be 0011. If you will press 4, data would be 0100. So basically this is 4-bit data coming out of this IC, HT9170 or MT8870, any IC you can use. Then this 4-bit data is fed to the microcontroller, then microcontroller will decide according to this data which relay the microcontroller should own, right? So this is simple working. Now let me just show you the wireless operation. So in the wireless operation I can use this mobile phone and I need to make a call on this number. Now you can see that by pressing 1, let me just open the keypad. If I press 1, bulb is on. If I press 2, bulb is off. If I press 3, motor is on. If I press 4, motor would be off. If I press 5, the hooter will be on. If I press 6, hooter would be off. So this is the wireless operation. Now this phone can be anywhere in the world, and this project can be also anywhere in the world, but still this phone will be able to control this project. Means any phone, if you just need to make a call on the GSM mobile number, like you can put a 250 rupee phone as well, like very cheap phone as well over here to build a wireless network. So this is how this is working. Now if you want to learn more about DTMF technology, you can watch the other video, link is given above. This is all about this project. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to download the data of this project, then you can go to the circuitsbazaar website.com, or you can also go to the description of this video. Thank you.